Until now, we have talked about spaces and their topological structures, the metric, the norm, and the inner product. Now we will look at something different, differentiable functions. We consider vector functions, functions that map an n-dimensional vector to an m-dimensional vector. So f of x is an m-dimensional vector, and each of its elements is a function of the vector x, which is n-dimensional. If each of these elements, the fi's, are continuous functions at some point, let's call this x0, we say that the vector function f is continuous at this point. And for short, we write this as the vector function being c0 at this point. If each of the elements are continuous everywhere in the set S, we say that the vector function is continuous in S. If each of the elements are not only continuous, but the first order derivative exists and is continuous, then the function f is continuously differentiable, and we write this c1 for short. As above, this can either be in a point, x0, or in a set S. If also the second order derivatives of all elements exist and are continuous, then the function f is 2 times continuously differentiable, and we write this c2. And so on, we can continue up to c infinity, which means that the function is continuously differentiable infinitely many times. And we then say that the function is smooth. We also need to know how to compute the Jacobian of a vector function. We will use this, for instance, in Lyapunov's indirect method for stability analysis. The Jacobian is simply found by taking the partial derivative of the first vector element f1, first with respect to x1, then with respect to x2, x3, and so on up to xn. This gives the first row of the Jacobian, and so we continue with f2 and all the way up to fm, taking the partial derivative first with respect to x1, x2, and so on up to xn. This gives an m times n matrix, which is the Jacobian of the vector function. And then we have the special case where m is 1. In other words, where the function maps an n-dimensional vector to a scalar. Let's call the function h. H of x is then a scalar function that maps the vector x, which has n elements, x1, up to xn. From the definition above, we see that the Jacobian of this is this vector, with 1 row and n columns, so it is an n-dimensional row vector. Sometimes we will work with a transpose of this. We then get a column vector instead. And this column vector is called the gradient of the scalar function. This we will use later in this course when using Lyapunov's direct method, Lyapunov control design, and feedback linearization for stability analysis and for control design.